Now we decided the patient is ready for weaning. So what's next? Here comes what we call SPT, which means spontaneous breathing trial. Basically, we want the patient to breathe on his own and pulling adequate tidal volume while ET tube still secured in place with very little or no help from the ventilator. That's what SBT is. Basically, we're trying to simulate the patient breathing on his own without the ventilator there. Of course, you need to do this while the ET tube is still secured, because the worst thing you could do for the patient is, okay, let's take the tube out, and then the patient still having difficulty breathing, and then you have to reintubate and put the ET tube back in with all the possible complication and trauma and pain that can happen from that. So we're trying to avoid that. All of this we're doing is to minimize the reintubation rate. We have to say that whatever you do, even if you follow all the protocols, everything is pass, there is still a risk of reintubation, but we're trying to minimize that. Excuse my draw again, I mean, it looks funny, but again, this is just to get you the idea. This is the ET tube, somebody, like this is a patient intubated. This is the inspiratory limb, expiratory limb, they meet, and this is the ventilator meet the endotracheal tube here. So the idea now, we want really to switch off all the support from the ventilator and see if the patient able to breathe or minimize the support. One way to do this is basically by disconnecting the patient from the ventilator while the ET tube is still secured in place, and then just provide oxygen to the patient and see how he breathes, right? Same like when we provide nasal cannula to the patient. The way we provide oxygen is by a piece, the name of this piece called T-piece, because it has the shape of letter T, and basically we provide oxygen through and look and see how the patient is breathing. Look at certain parameters, we'll come to these parameters, what are the objective parameters to say he's ready, but subjectively you can look how fast he's breathing and how much like respiratory rate, how much tidal volume he's pulling, his auto sat. These quick things can give you an idea, because technically the patient is breathing through a straw. The ET tube depends on the diameter. The smaller the diameter, the more resistance. So it's not even easy for the patient to breathe through the ET tube. If he passed this T piece, that tells you probably he's ready for the ET tube to come out. These quickly subjective values, you can look at the monitor and see and look at the if he's ready. We'll come to the objective size. So the first thing, this is what we call T-piece trial. T-piece, basically disconnect him from the ventilator and provide the patient with oxygen through the ET tube. The problem with T-piece, as I said, is mainly the patient, there will be increased work of breathing because he's pulling air through a small tube. The smaller the diameter, for example 6 or 6.5, will be harder to breathe. But again, that could be good, because if the patient is breathing through this small T piece trial, some small ET tube, then that means he is ready. I have to say this is not the most common one we use, and I'll talk about the most common one we use in the next video, which is using pressure support mode of ventilation as a way of weaning.